Hey YouTube, AppleX142 here, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how you can downgrade from iOS 13 beta back to the public release of iOS 12. So if you've already upgraded to iOS 13 beta and you've decided that all the bugs just aren't worth it and you just want to go back to iOS 12, you can do that. But unfortunately there is going to be one major caveat to this, and that is that you can't do it without actually erasing your device's data. So you'll have to actually restore it to factory settings in order to do this. Now this can be a problem if you've taken a backup of your device after you've updated to iOS 13, since you won't be able to use that backup now to restore it to iOS 12, since it was created with a newer version. You're only going to be able to keep your data if you have a backup from iOS 12. So that's just something to bear in mind. You shouldn't really have installed this on a device that you use mainly anyway. So if that's an issue, then unfortunately, you really shouldn't have installed iOS 13. But if you are in that position, then unfortunately you're gonna have to just save all of your data elsewhere and then restore and then put it all back on your device. Unfortunately, it's a bit of a longer process, but it's something you're gonna have to bear in mind if you wanna do this, since the downgrading without updating or without erasing your device doesn't seem to work with iOS 13 to iOS 12 like it has with previous betas. But yeah, now that that's out of the way, we can actually get into the guide. So you're gonna need a computer to do this, obviously. It could be a Windows or Mac computer, and you don't need any additional software other than iTunes. So all you need to do is have iTunes on your device or on your computer. It needs to be iTunes 12 or newer, just so it supports iOS 12, and then you can good to go. Now, if you go to the link in the video description, you're going to find my full written guide on how to do this, so it's worth reading that and reading the warnings there as well if you want to follow the guide that way. But you're also going to need to come here if you want to download the IPSW file that you need to restore to for your device. So you just go down to the written guide section and then just tap on the first line where it says here, and it'll open up ipsw.me, which is just the website for downloading IPSW files. Simply go through here and select the correct one for your device. So let's say it's a 10R. It would be any one of these ones that has got a green tick next to it, which means you can restore to it. If it has a red X, it will no longer be able to restore to it, since it's no longer being signed by Apple. So now, all we need to do once we've got our two files is open up iTunes on our computer. This can be a Mac or Windows PC, like I said before. And you're just going to need to plug your device into your computer using a USB cable, and then just go to the devices menu in the top menu here, and you should see something that looks like this. As you can see, I've got an iPhone 6S here running iOS 13.0 Beta 1. And all we're going to need to do is hold down the Shift key if you're on Windows, or the Alt or Option key if you're on Mac. You have to make sure you hold down those keys when you press the next button. So I'm going to hold down the Shift key, and then I'm going to just click on where it says Restore iPhone. That's going to prompt me to select an IPSW file that I want to restore to. And as you can see, I have the 12.3.1 IPSW file here for the iPhone 6S that is still being signed. So if you're watching this video in the future at some point, this may not necessarily be the latest signed version, so make sure you download the latest version that is actually available. And then just click on open, and it'll ask you if you want to restore and erase your device, and just click on restore. Now this, from this point onwards, you can still cancel it up until it actually starts to restore your device. You've got basically until it finishes extracting the software to cancel this, but yeah, from this point on it is going to restore and erase everything on the device, so just make sure you have all of your data saved before this. You can do the similar thing with holding the Shift key and then pressing the check update button, and that does prompt you to select an IPSW file as well. However, if you try to do that going from iOS 13 to iOS 12, it will simply error, since there's some kind of incompatibility there that is stopping it from working. So unfortunately you won't be able to downgrade that way like you have been able to in the past. So that's just something to bear in mind. But that is pretty much all there is to this. This is going to go ahead and just perform a very normal restore here, and you'll come back up to a fresh install of iOS 12 on your device. It really is that simple, and there's not really a whole lot else to it. Like I said, all the links you're going to need for this are in the video description below. If you want to try iOS 13 and you haven't yet, I'll also put my guide down there on how to install iOS 13 beta if you want to do that. And then, yeah, that's pretty much all there is to this. So like the video if you liked it, leave a comment if you have any questions, and as always, don't forget to subscribe.